We are at Jetavana Park, where the Buddha spent 19 rain retreats. He's persuaded to come here by a rich local merchant called Ananda Pindika, who he met in Rajgiri. Thus, he built the Buddha a monastery here, and this bird tree is believed to be an offspring of one of the trees planted by Buddha's main disciple Ananda.
සඳහා අපි මේ වෙලාවේ බුදු ගුණ සිහි කරමින් යන ගමනම ඔබට සාර්ථක කරගත හැකියි.
To assist us to remember the teachings and the qualities of the Buddha, the venerable monk is here, chanting one of the sermons given by the Buddha here at Jetavana Park. This is all that remains of the seven-story mansion of the banker Ananda Pindika, who got his name because he used his wealth to help the poor. The story of Angulimala is a well-known episode in the life story of the Buddha. As a punishment for stealing, he was ordered by his teacher to kill 1,000 people and bring their fingers to him as evidence. After killing 999, his mother was to be his last victim, when Angulimala met the Buddha on his way. So he thought he'll kill the Buddha instead. But through his powers of compassion, Gautama Buddha managed to conquer Angulimala and convert him to Buddhism. Angulimala then became a devout Buddhist and a monk and lived in this cave for the rest of his life. During his lifetime, Gautama Buddha performed miraculous powers to convince skeptics on three occasions. He performed one here to impress the Jains who were questioning his wisdom. A stupa was built later to mark this spot. Our next stop will be Varanasi or Benares. It is a long journey from Shravasti. The workhorse of the Indian rural farm sector. Farmers have gathered here for a buffalo auction.
There are some buffaloes in the lorries.
And some have already got their bargain. Another tea break, and this time a crash course in Indian cooking too. We have now arrived in Varanasi, or Benares, the historic name for this city during the Buddha's time. This is a city of over 3 million people. This is the deer park at Saranath, which is just a 10-kilometer ride from Varanasi. Gautama Buddha gave his first sermon here to the five ascetics. The Dharma Chakra Sutra, or the middle path, was revealed to them here, and the five of them became the Buddha's first five disciples. Since this is the place where the order of monks, the Sangha, was born. At one time, there were 30 monasteries here, where over 1,500 monks lived. The Muslim invaders have destroyed most of these in the 12th century. These remnants of the Ashoka Pillar have been excavated by archaeologists. This is the Dharmaka Stupa, built by Emperor Ashoka in 300 BC to mark the place where Gautama Buddha gave the first sermon. Just behind the Dharmaka Stupa, to the east, is the Mulgankuti Vihara, or the Isipathana Temple. This was built in 1931 by the Mahabodhi Society to fulfill the spiritual needs of Buddhist pilgrims visiting Saranath. Every evening at 7 o'clock, monks gather here and chant the Buddha's first sermon. Is one of the holiest places of Hindu pilgrimage, especially on the banks of River Ganges. Today we are making an early morning start at 6 o'clock to visit the Ganges River. These are offerings that Hindus make to the Ganges River to bring you good luck. Floating souvenir shops were a nuisance for some of us with their pestering sale tactics. Yet, if you needed some souvenirs to take back home, there were many bargains to be had.
I don't mind drinking it.
Banks of the famous Ganges River in Varanasi. In the Buddhist scriptures, this city was called Varanasi. This is not exactly a location for Buddhist pilgrims, but it is an important one for Hindu pilgrims who come here to wash their sins away by bathing in the sacred Ganges River. After a blessing from the Brahmin priest, these Hindu devotees are cleansing their sins on this chilly winter morning in the freezing temperatures. It really takes some devotion and motivation to do this. Varanasi is not complete without seeing how the world-famous Banaras silk saris are made. Here we watch the process from separating the silk threads to making the patterns for the weaving machine. And the weaving itself, still very traditional, though India is a world leader in modern IT. This is the showroom at the back of the factory. They really intoxicate you with choice so that you just can't walk away without buying. And I was tempted to buy my first sari, a Banaras silk.
Oh yes, nice, really.
Tracing the footsteps of Buddha, but we haven't finished our trip to India. We are now waiting for a train to take us to Jaipur and Agra to visit the famous Taj Mahal and finally to Delhi where we will be flying off. We hope you have enjoyed the trip as much as we have. Bye bye.